Hello everyone, this is me Satya here and I'm doing a remaining month of November reading. Start from the 22nd through the 30th of November 2020. This is going to be for the sign of Libra. Let's see what is coming up for you guys for the remaining month time. I will be adding charms, I will be pulling out oracle cards as well, so stay tuned. And while I shuffle the cards, let me remind you it's a general reading if you're not resonating with everyone out there. So always pick the messages which are resonating and leave the rest. For personal readings, you can always reach out to me on my email ID in the description box. You can also follow me on Instagram where I do upload daily readings. So yeah, let's dive into the reading. Let's find out what is heading towards you guys starting tomorrow. Today, because I'm recording this on the 22nd of November. So let's see what is coming up for you guys for the remaining month time. Let's begin. The Empress, paired up with the Temperance, Nine of Wands, King of Swords, Ten of Swords, Queen of Swords. Somebody really have, it can be your energy, it can be the energy of the person that you are dealing with. Somebody really has to basically stop controlling the connection here. I feel like, you know, it can be your energy, it can be the energy of the person that you are dealing with who is trying to have a hold on this connection that you have with the specific someone. Maybe you are trying to control them and the situation right now, or maybe they are trying to control you and the connection right now and the situation too. But in actuality, like both of you, you know, whoever is trying hard to get the control under their, you know, under their control or something like that, none of you is going to get successful. Either one of you, whoever it is that is trying to control and be the dominant one in this connection, they will have to ultimately give up. Maybe it's the masculine energy who is trying to do so, but whoever it is that's trying to control the connection right now, they have to basically let go of it. Until and unless they let go of that control, need to be the dominant in the connection, need to be the, I feel like, you know, somebody really needs to put their ego down or put their ego aside. Because maybe that's the only reason why the connection is not moving forward, why the connection is having so many obstacles in this, why situations are not getting better between you and your specific someone. Somebody is basically trying to control the connection. Now, for very few of you, maybe the person who is trying to control the connection between the two of you could be another person. It can be the mother of your spouse, it can be your mother, or it can be father figure as well. But yes, there is a strong chance of somebody else trying to control the connection of you and your specific someone. In that situation, I feel like, you know, the intention of this person who is trying to have a hold on this connection is not good, is not right. So in that situation, you might need to basically, you know, if you could sense that there is another person involved in this situation, I don't think that this person is going to be somebody your person is in attachment with. I feel like, you know, it is going to be a mother figure or a father figure, somebody who is dominant and somebody who is controlling. So in that situation, your person or whoever if it's your mother or your father, then you have to take stand for yourself. If it's their mother, their father, they have to take stand for this connection. Because until and unless they do so, until and unless they say no to them and do what they feel like doing in this connection, the connection is not going to move forward. So somebody is basically trying to control the connection, be that you, be that your person, or be that their father figure, mother figure, or your father figure or mother figure. Somebody has to let go of the control here. Until and unless that happens, nothing positive is going to happen in this connection. I feel like, you know, this time is going to be the time when, you know, it is going to get revealed to many people out there that there is somebody who's controlling the connection here, which is why there is some sort of stagnation in the connection that you have with a specific someone. And in the deck, we do have the Five of Wands. I feel like, you know, if your person is behaving a certain way and you are unaware of it, like, you know, why they are not giving you the commitment, why they are, you know, being a certain way, it must be because of their parents. It must, you know, the connection that you have with your person is undeniable, meant to happen. You know, there is nothing that can make that, you know, change. But something needs to end. Like, you know, there is something that needs to end. So you could be together forever. The stress levels are getting high in this situation during the remaining month of November time. And it's like, you know, it's not going to be a good week for the two of you, to be very honest. But yes, ultimately it's all going to go away. But for that, again, somebody has to make a choice. Somebody has to make a stand for themselves, for the connection that they have with you, or maybe you have to stand tall for yourself and for the connection that you have with a specific someone. And maybe you will have to go against your parents. Maybe they have to go against their parents to pursue a connection with you. Somebody has to basically take the charge of this connection back in the hand of the one involved in this connection. Maybe the connection is pretty much controlled by another person. But I feel like, you know, it is meant to happen. Whatever you have with a specific someone, it is meant to happen. But yes, somebody really needs to take decision for themselves. You know, somebody, maybe somebody elder in the family could be the case as well. Maybe elder sister or elder brother as well. But somebody's trying to make the decisions for you two to get, you know, for you two basically, or for either one of you. Maybe your person's parents want them to get married to someone else, and they are doing nothing right now. They have to make a choice. They have to make a decision. And I don't think that you have anything to be fearful of. Ultimately, you both are going to be together. But yes, there is some sort of situation created, which somebody has to, you know, take control of. So things could, you know, move forward in the connection that you have with a specific someone. Let's see what the Earth has to add to the reading for you guys for the remaining month time. Outdoors, go outside, get some fresh air, connect with the nature to relieve the stress and gain new creative ideas. You really have to calm yourself and then think of what you can do in this situation to get the, you know, things moving in your favor. Maybe you are taking a lot of stress around it. Maybe you need to just relax around it. So you could think straight. So you could think, you know, positively around the situation. Right now, maybe the circumstances are like, you know, so heavily intense that you are unable to see what can you do in this situation. So maybe going out in nature is going to help you a lot. Asking or seeking help from the, you know, spirit guides and nature itself is going to help you a lot in this situation. So you could find a better way forward. How could you deal with your parents? How could you deal with your person to make things moving in the right direction? You could find out some ideas if you spend some time outdoors. Let's see one more card here. Adjustments are required. So let me take one more card here because I was holding the cards upside down. What do you need to release? You really need to, try and figure out, like, you know, what is it that you need to release? What is it that you are holding right now? You just do that. If you are the one who's trying to, you know, have a hold on this connection, you really have to let loose of that control. If it is the control, coming from an outside source, they have to let it go. They have to, you know, you have to make them let, you know, make them understand that they cannot tell you or dictate you how your connection should be like. So just be mindful of that. Let's see what the charms has to add to the reading now. So we do have one alphabet, which is a T. It can be your name initial of the person that you are dealing with. Dove and dark. Maybe you're going to see a lot of them along with the rabbit. If you see any white animals during this time, there will be some sort of a guidance coming for you in that, you know, particular scene that you would be having. You know, suppose if you are walking on the road and you see a duck or dove or any white bird or any white animal, it's going to be like, you know, there is some sort of guidance around that, you know, scenario that you would be having. Try to have peace from within, and try to see and seek guidance with a peaceful heart, and try to be happy. Like, you know, try to relax. So you could, again, like, you really have to relax yourself during this time. Five of Wands and Six of Wands. If you could take the stress levels down, you could get a, you know, quick route forward towards what you want. So yeah, that's pretty much it coming up for you for the remaining month time. If the reading resonates with you, do like, subscribe, and share. If you're willing to get a personal reading, you can always reach out to me for that on my email ID in the description box. Till I do the next reading, take care. Bye bye.